محمد الإيسار. محمد الإيسار The Art of Lying. محمد الإيسار.
Mr. Contest Chairman, fellow Toastmasters, dear guests, most lenient panel of judges, I came here to share with you some of my expertise in life. For those of you who don't know me, I am a certified seatbelt, a competent liar. Lying is very bad if you don't have the skills. Don't worry, I will teach you all the skills that you need. But before I proceed, I would like to evaluate the skills that you already have. Those of you who don't lie, I want them please to stand up and to stay up until I tell them to sit down. If you don't lie, please stand up and stay up. Stay up, please. Those of you who didn't stand up, if you ever feel reluctant to lie, those are the people to consult. And those of you who didn't stand up, thank you very much for making me feel home. I apologize for you, I really underestimated your skills. Maybe I don't need to teach you skills. What I need to teach you are the ethics of lying. Lying is very useful. Lying can save you from dying. Can you tell your wife you love another woman? And still eat her cooking? Please don't get me wrong. I'm not urging you to lie. I'm begging you to do it. With ethics, please. The first ethic of lying is lie frankly. If somebody knocks the door wanting to see you and you don't want to see him, what would you do? You send your kid and ask him to open the door and tell this gentleman that you are not here. And then your kid will look at you saying, Daddy, but you are here. Do you want me to lie? You just simply say, Son, by the time you open the door, I will be there. Another ethic of lying is lie politely. Instead of telling somebody, you are the most stupid man on earth, you could always say, you are much smarter than many other people who haven't existed yet. Another ethic of lying is lie kindly. Never lie to people who are weaker than you. Only lie to people who are stronger than you. Shall you lie to your kids?
No.
Never. Shall you lie to your bosses?
Yes.
And forever. Shall you lie to your wives?
Yes.
It depends. Who is stronger? But if you are equally strong, exchange lies. Another method of lying is lie reasonably. I mean, when you lie, don't exaggerate. You see, when you exaggerate, we liars are going to lose our credibility. For liars, credibility matters. Believe me. Do you still believe me? Liars trust each other. Another ethic of lying is lie consistently. tell you why, continue to love him. Never be shy. The most important thing is that your next lie should be consistent with the previous one. Don't confuse your fit. One day I was preaching my kid about how bad lying is. Of course, before I was certified. Then we heard his mother shouting in the living room, "Who spilled the coffee here?" My son was about to jump and tell his mother that it was I who spilled the coffee. I told him, "Son, please don't." He said, "Daddy, are you asking me to lie?" I said, "No, son. All I'm asking you to do is to delay the truth." 2 minutes later, the truth was discovered. And I had to make another. You see, you are learning. I'm really proud of you. I just told him, "You see, son, I deliberately lied to teach you a lesson. That the truth will be discovered sooner or later." And as I finished my sentence, my daughter came running down the stairs to her mother saying, "Sorry, mommy, for spilling the coffee." Then I said, "You see, son, even if you lie and confess the things that you didn't do to protect your own daughter, the truth will be still discovered." Then my daughter said, "Daddy, this has nothing to do with the one you spilled here. This is another cup of coffee." Then I felt dizzy and I was about to fall. "If you have those symptoms, stop lying immediately. They call it lying overdose." Another very important ethic of lying is you should never, ever lie to me.